I'm a positive person. I believe in change. I'm willing to take leaps of faith. But when you deal with the convict, you want to see conversion before he goes out. The fact that the deal itself does not respect, leave aside Israel, the deal does not respect America. There is honor to Iran here in every page. There is more respect here for the Iranian Majlis than to American Congress. So how do you think that if you do not have any signs of conversion, then the leader, the supreme leader, goes and talk about the legitimacy of death to America? If you want a deal, if you want conversion, if you want peace, you need to be respected. You need to be honored, definitely in the Middle East. Look, some marriages go bad. But if the evening before the wedding, one of the partners says about the other one that his death is legitimate, where will the wedding go? What can you expect of the future? So again, there are achievements here. There is definitely goodwill here. But the dangers are serious. And I think these 60 days are 60 days of reckoning. It's a great opportunity for your great democracy to discuss this and think about what's the implications of this.
If, in fact, you believe and you do everything you've said, and if, in fact, you have studied it as you have, and if, in fact, you know the Middle East as well as you do, then your editorial position should be, please, American Congress, stop this deal. It should be. You're not intellectually honest if that's not your position. I mean, you want to dance around the fact that you're a friend of America and you're all that, blah, blah, blah. But if, in fact, you believe everything you just said for the 21st century, you have to hope America does not support this deal.
My hopes
are
different.
You can't walk away from that idea.
I'm serious about what I say, and I mean what I say.
And what is
more? I think, look, there are serious implications. We are at a crossroad where all the options are bad. This is basically what it's not the end, it's the beginning. It's a new beginning. And all options, because stopping the deal now, where we are, will have tremendous costs. I'm an Israeli. I have no right to tell or to ask American senators and congressmen to take that decision.